Have you ever wondered why there are so many different languages in the world? Well, a study in history, sociology, and archaeology will shed great light into that. But also, you'll see this explained in your reading of Genesis 11 today. But additionally, in Genesis 11, we see what is often referred to as the Tower of Babel. Now, you may ask, what is this about and why did this happen? You see, the people of Earth were unified, working together, building a structure. You may ask, why would God confuse their language to ultimately put a stop to this? Doesn't He want people to work together? You see, building a city in and of itself wasn't an offense to God. However, look at two specific ways in which the builders of Babel disobeyed the Lord. Genesis 11:4 records, "Then they said, 'Come, let us build ourselves a city with a tower that reaches to the heavens so that we may make a name for ourselves. Otherwise, we'll be scattered over the face of the whole earth.'" Did you catch that phrase? "So that we may make a name for ourselves." They wanted everyone to know how great they were. Their pride and arrogance, well, honestly, it had gotten out of hand. But there's another dynamic in play. God specifically told Noah and his descendants to spread out and fill the earth. That's in Genesis 9:1. See, beyond trying to be better than everyone else, the people of Babel were disobeying God's command. God told them to disperse, but they built a city for the express purpose of not being scattered over the face of the earth. That's Genesis 11:4. You see, pride and disobedience don't go hand in hand with a life that's surrendered to God. And more than your work, God wants your heart. And He'll do anything to remove an idol in your life so that your heart is soft and sensitive to Him. So today, surrender your heart afresh to the Lord. Live for His glory and for the good of others. Follow His will in His way. That's the way to make for a great day.